You know, there's a reason more customers choose one New Zealand company to build their homes. Trust.
GJ Gardner have worked up and down the country for over 20 years now,
and they've earned a solid reputation with Kiwis.
And you've just voted them Reader's Digest Most Trusted Home Builder again. So, if you're thinking about creating the home you've always wanted, talk to the team at GJ Gardner Homes, New Zealand's most trusted home builder, officially.
There's a city somewhere that isn't so big, as large on life. A smart little city where the great outdoors is right on our doorstep. Where everything is close and the people even closer. Where making friends is pulling up a chair, grabbing a bite, drinking it all in. Where you'll find extraordinary flavours, talented makers, movers and shakers, around every corner, down every lane. And the best that you can get is a stone's throw that way, or that way. Nothing is too far or too far out. A place to get going, to have fun, to wind it up, or wind down. Let's get closer. Extraordinary Nelson City.
When building a new home, you want to feel confident, knowing you're in good hands.
I was renting and I looked at building. I picked up on some bad spending habits for me to have a healthier deposit.
How would you summarise the process of building with GJ?
So my career is in the New Zealand Defence Force. It requires me to travel around the country and overseas. The build was conducted while I was overseas. Communication between myself and GJ was simple. And the day I got the keys, I was so excited that I moved in straight away. And I really love my home.
Talk to New Zealand's most trusted building team. Visit gjgardner.co.nz.
Finding your way to extraordinary can take a little time, or maybe a lot. It depends on your perspective and what you're looking for. Surprising flavours, amazing angles, big tastes, unforgettable views. Arriving somewhere as far from ordinary as you can imagine. You'll find a natural place, pristine and perfect as can be. Native birds, dense bush, wildlife at your fingertips. Water lapping, impossibly golden beaches. Walking through an ancient wilderness, returning to itself all this time. Named for an explorer, but not the only one, not the first, and not the last. Will you be next? Find your way to extraordinary Abel Tasman.
The digital age means that your sport events can now be streamed live to national and global audiences with flexible delivery across multiple devices and platforms. NZSport.tv and Digital Vision Live work together to create multiple solutions for online broadcasting of sport events. We believe we make a real difference and provide a better live streaming experience. We can interface seamlessly with all broadcast options, including Sky Sport Live and Sky Sport Next, and simulcast to social media and other live TV. Digital Vision Live has also developed our own platform that provides a reliable and consistent stream with superior quality and unlimited viewership, as well as on-demand playback. This gives us full control over the broadcast and means we can adapt to the many challenges of a live sports production. We can also add pay-per-view options. For seamless streaming and consistent quality away from land-based internet, we use multiple cellular networks and we work directly with providers to develop network solutions if needed. Best of all, however, with everything we do, we can provide off-site production via remote studio or virtual server with mixing of multiple cameras, remote commentary and online scoring. This means a lower footprint at the venue and reduced costs. Another advantage, you can access as much of the platform as you wish and make use of multiple playlists for archived games and highlights and embed them on your own website. Together, nzsport.tv and Digital Vision Live utilise a wealth of experience to provide quality streaming of local, national and international events. Anything live streaming in sport, you should be talking to us. We are sure we can help.
Hi, I'm Dean Wilson and we're at the Tahunanui Beach Reserve for the first round of the GJ Gardner Homes New Zealand Beach Volleyball Tour. We've got the Nelson Super Slam. It's the first of five stops on the national tour this year, and thanks to Sky Sport Next, we're about to go live and see some semi-finals and finals action here at the beautiful Nelson.
Good morning and welcome to the GJ Gardner New Zealand Beach Tour, the first of four events here down at sunny Nelson. You're joined by Trent Webby, I'll be your host, and we are here for the first semi-final of the women's between number one seeds Shauna Polly and Julia Tilly against number six seeds Melanie Vanout and Liz Hanna. Conditions today are looking pretty sunny, as always here in Nelson, with a moderate breeze coming off the shore. We have our team of Vanout and Hanna in the pink, and Shauna Polly and Julia Tilly with the white visors on. Before we get started into this game, just a little bit of background about these teams. Liz Hanna and Melanie Vanout had a massive win yesterday evening to make it out of the contenders bracket, beating number four seeds. Shauna Polly and Julia Tilly winning both of their games yesterday and staying on the winner's side of the bracket. Now this is a double elimination tournament, being a five-star competition here at the New Zealand Beach Tour. And double elimination means that you have one extra life. If you lose one game, you must win every other game to stay alive. But if you lose two games throughout the tournament, you are out of the tournament. And we've seen four of our teams lose two games yesterday, and we're down to our final four women's teams and final four men's teams playing today in these first two semi-finals, with the finals being played later on today, kicking off at 2 p.m. On the screen here, you'll see Shauna Polly and Julia Tilly. And joining the field, we have Melanie Vanout and Liz Hanna. Now, Julia Tilly entering the field, based out of Mount Maunganui, home of the beach volleyball here in New Zealand. And her partner Shauna Polly, coming from the landlocked city of Hamilton, but regularly training over at Mount Maunganui. This pairing is probably a household name in the beach volleyball scene, having played together for the last 5 to 7 years on the tour. And the new pairing of Liz Hanna and Melanie Vanout, a new pairing from Christchurch. These two players have just taken to the sand this season and will be pleased to be playing here in the semi-final. First serve from Julia Tilley. Liz Hunter with an overline. Shauna Polly chasing it down. Julia Tilley putting a free ball in. Big block to start it off with by Shauna Polly. So, first point going to Team Tilley Polly down here at the Nelson Super Slam, sponsored by GJ Gardner Homes. We have first ref up on the stand, Mike Kopp, from down in Otago, and second ref being Wallace from Christchurch. That ball just going too deep from Liz Hunter. So we've seen the first 2 points go to Tilley Polly. Strong aggression starting out from the gate from Team Vanort and Hunter. As you can see by that flag in the corners, we do have a little bit of a breeze coming offshore. Scramble play. Going on two by Tilley Polly. Free net. Melanie Vanort winning the first point for Team Hunter and Vanort with a tape roll off the top tape, and you'll see that here in this replay, set by Liz off the top tape, slowing the pace down. Julia Tilley just sitting too far in the deep. And a cut shot by Julia Tilley, one of her signature shots. You'll see that probably play a few times here in this first women's semi-final at the Nelson Super Slam. Shauna Polly with a jump serve. Taken well by Liz, pretty high. Deep pokey by Liz Hunter. Free ball over, Shauna Polly. Into the deep corner and wins the point. A little bit of the combination here, Shauna Polly and Julia Tilley. You'll see Shauna being one of stronger spikers in this competition, where Julia Tilley is one of the craftier players, playing a lot of shots, which are like cuts and overlines. We'll talk a bit more about those shortly. Liz Hunter with the side out there with a pokey cross court. And those for you at home, what a pokey means is that you cannot tip the ball with an open hand. You must play the ball across the court. If you're going to tip it, you must use the knuckles. Hence the term pokey. Covered set by Julia Tilley. Going on two. Another block. And there's a cut shot there by Shauna Polly. So that brings up our first side change of 5-2 to Tilley Polly. And in the game of beach volleyball, teams must switch ends every 7 points to ensure that there is no bias with the weather conditions. Some sides have more wind, some sides have more sun. To make it an even match, they switch sides in every multiple of 7. Julia serving down line, just going too wide and out. Bringing up a score of 3-5 for Nort to serve. Serve going deep by Melanie Vanort. Close serve, Shauna Polly, deep corner. Scramble ball, we got a free ball. Unfortunately, Hunter digs that one into the net. Another float serve coming from Shauna Polly. And that one just going too wide, cut shot by Liz Hunter. No wind helping them there. Now in beach volleyball, there's usually two variants of a serve, and we're seeing Shauna use both of them. She's doing a float serve from this left side of the court, which is an open hand serve that drifts around, just floats up in the air, hence why it's called a float serve. It just uses the breeze and moves around. The alternative is a jump serve where you put top spin on the ball, and you can either do that standing, but more commonly seen when a player tosses up, jumps up, and hits it above the height of the net. Float serve by Liz Hunter. Great pick by Benoit. Free net. Another great pick by Shauna Polly, but having to go free ball. And a cut shot there by Shauna Pollard to win the point. So we're 1 point away for a side change here. Julia Tilly to serve. She'll be choosing the float serve as well here. An aggressive attack there by Hannah, winning the point using Shauna Polly's block. So Melanie Vanor to go back to serve after the side change. A little bit about Vanor. She works, I believe, at St. Andrew's College down in Christchurch as a beach volleyball coach. What a lovely job that must be. Cut shot read well by Vanort. Free ball coming over. However, second rev was calling a net touch there. Now what a net touch is, the net is out of play. No player can touch the net in during the play as it's a violation and can interfere with the game. So that is an unforced error from Team Vanort Hunter. Jump serve and an ace. That brings up our first ace of this women's semi-final here at the GJ Gardner Nelson Super Slam. Going to Shauna Polly with the jump serve now. Straight between the two players. We call that the husband and wife serve. It can split up partnerships with arguments about whose ball it was. Unforced error by Vanort, spiking that ball into the net. Set possibly being a little bit too low from Hannah. Another jump serve, great serve by Shauna Polly. Free ball here, chance to attack. Well played by Shauna Polly. And she does well to execute that one. Getting the ball with a one arm touch and getting up to shoot that ball back to the line. Another service ace there by Shauna Polly. An ace is considered whether the second player on the team is able to touch the ball, determines if there's an ace. And we see there that Liz Hunter digging the ball, it goes too far left. Vanort unable to recycle the ball, get a good set. So that brings up a timeout called by Hunter and Vanort. They're just going to try to slow the game down here and maybe change tactics. They're going to see if they can break the service streak that Shauna Polly is playing. A little bit more about some of our team players. Liz Hunter actually comes from North Carolina. She's been living in New Zealand for a few years now, based down in Christchurch. Both Vanort and Hunter play for the Pioneer Panthers women's team in indoor volleyball. So they've played with each other for quite a while now. However, they both have not played beach volleyball. We have not seen them on the New Zealand beach tour before. So they are a new pairing out here. Shauna Polly with a jump serve. Free ball going over. And a big swing there by Shauna Polly down the line. great wide set there by Julia Tilley. We've seen a lot of control out there from both teams, more importantly from Shauna Polly and Julia Tilley as they're taking this lead 15-5. Another great serve. And another service ace. No, that's not considered an ace, but that is another great serve by Shauna Polly. And that brings up the technical timeout. So a technical timeout is a free timeout that neither team needs to take themselves. It's when the score equals a total of 21. And this just gives both teams a chance to have a 1 minute break. And it's a good chance for both teams to change tactics if needed. Now, Tilley Polly probably won't change tactics. I think they've figured out what they need to do, and it'll be more important for Hannah and Vinort here to discuss what they're doing or how they can change the receive of the serve, which is seems to be causing a little bit of havoc out there on the court. A little bit of difference. The timeout we saw before was only a 30-second timeout, which each team has one timeout per set. The technical timeout is a 1 minute timeout, and then in between games is about 3 minutes. Between each set, there's a 3 minute break. So with a side change there, Shauna Polly will probably head back to her float serve. And that ball just going too far wide. Now the difference between a float and a jump serve, a reason why Shauna's switching on both ends is because there is a little bit of a breeze out here today in Nelson, sunny Nelson. So when there is a wind coming head on, it's better to do a jump serve, a top spin, as it will drop quicker. And with a little bit of breeze behind you, float serve can be tricky to play, as it will float around a little bit more. Recycle set by Julia Tilley. She tries to put that across court, across her body, but unfortunately has an unforced error into the net. Here we'll see the replay here. It's a difficult ball to play when the set's real high, as sometimes you get underneath the ball and you lose vision of where the net and where the other players are. It's a very important to stay behind the ball, as we've just seen. Julia Tilley just playing there behind the ball. She sees the court and where the space is and puts the ball into the space. So that brings up 18-7 with Julia Tilley to serve. And there's a service error hitting the antenna of the beach volleyball net. The antennas indicate where the out is, and anything played outside that, including the post, is considered out of play. Great peel there by Liz Hunter, but unfortunately the tape roll off the top of the tape, off the top of the net, means that the ball slows down. Liz Hunter pulling off just too much and not able to get a clean dig on that ball. It was the right play though. Liz Hunter just approaching underneath that ball. I mentioned that before. You must stay behind the ball in order to see where the net is, as well as the other players on the other side of the net. So this brings up set point with 20-8 for Tilley Polly. Shauna Polly likely to do the jump serve here again. Oh, she's choosing for the float. Free ball going over. Shauna Polly takes. To the Tilley, puts it up. Good touch by Melanie Vinor, but unfortunately unable to go forward. And that brings up the end of our first set here at the women's semi-final. I'm your host, Trent G. Webby, and we'll join you shortly for the second set of the women's semi-final here at the GJ Gardner Homes Nelson Super Slam.
You know there's a reason more customers choose one New Zealand company to build their homes. Trust. GJ Gardner have worked up and down the country for over 20 years now, and they've earned a solid reputation with Kiwis. And
You've just voted them Reader's Digest Most Trusted Home Builder again. So, if you're thinking about creating the home you've always wanted, talk to the team at GJ Gardner Homes, New Zealand's most trusted home builder, officially.
Oh. And I'm the sports director at Nayland College, and, but I'm the side president of TBA. So it's not like, but beach hasn't really been my thing, so Dave, but I've known Dave since he was this high, so,
So you know the sport, as they
talk about it a little bit.
So talk to people, obviously, sometimes they're looking at home, have no clue what the heck's going on. Sometimes I always use terms and I realise, oh, someone who doesn't know volleyball,
or even not talk about the aerials and that, you know, just giving a little bit of more sort of background to that sport.
And we're back here for the second set of the women's semi-final here at the Nelson Super Slam, sponsored by GJ Gardner Homes. We're down here at the beautiful sunny Tahuna Nui Reserve, where the wind's just starting to pick up a little bit, coming from the left side of your screen, as you can see there on that flag. A bit of a westerly wind coming across the court, and we'll see probably some of the players using that to their advantage here in this second set of the women's semi-final between the combination of Julia Tilley and Shauna Polly against Liz Hannah and Melanie Vanork. First serve going deep by Melanie Vanork. So we've seen the first 2 points here being service errors from both teams. Hopefully not a picture of what's to come. We'll see some of that get cleaned up, and we'll see some beautiful rallies coming through here in the second set of the New Zealand Beach Tour. Cycle set by Shauna Polly, but Julia Tilley shooting that one just too long. Going out past the baseline. Liz Hannah with the serve, float serve. Good pick. Go on two there by Liz Hannah, or possibly a touch on the block. Liz Hannah in the right position but unable to get the ball up. Reading that play very well. Service ace there by Shauna Polly, who's been getting probably about the fifth service ace we've seen from Shauna Polly today. Bringing a combination of both float and jump serves. Shauna Polly being the first Commonwealth athlete to represent New Zealand at beach volleyball at the Commonwealth Games back in 2018. She paired up with Kelsey Wills, another Waikato-based player who no longer plays beach volleyball but has converted to rugby and is now part of the Black Ferns team. Great dig there by Shauna Polly, read well. Unfortunately hitting that one into the net, probably not drifting as wide as she was expecting, and that's probably based on that cross-court breeze, meaning the set dropping inside her body. Another deep serve there by Melanie Vanork. Julia going for the tip. Melanie Vanork reading that one again, but unfortunately able to pass. Taking the ball high off the top of the hands. You can't set the first ball in beach volleyball unless it's hard driven. However, you can do what's called a tomahawk, where your hands are together and a fist-like formation. Great cut, cross-court cut there by Liz Hannah. Seeing the space. We'll see her hit just over top of Shauna Polly. Float serve down the line. And we see some power there from Giulietelli hitting into this middle of the course. Seam ball. A seam ball being between the block and the backcourt player. Hard to defend. It's all about space awareness. Shauna Polly having her first service error, hitting the jump serve possibly without any topspin, drifting out the back. Good peel there by Liz Hunter, but unfortunately could not get that ball up. Something you don't see so much in indoor volleyball, peeling off the net. It's a chance where you think that the opposition is not able to attack the ball with an aggressive attack, so you peel off the net to take more space to defend any shots. Good read there by Giulietelli, but unable to make that ball go in the direction of Shauna Polly. And we've seen a bit more of a contestant match here with the score equaling 7-6. Tilly Polly still having the lead, but it's side out volleyball here at the moment. Going both ways, 1-1. Good dig there by Melanie Vinort. Chance to put it away, and unfortunately, hits it into the net. Brings up our second side change here, a combination of 14 points. Tilly Polly leading by 2, 8-6. Shauna Polly choosing to serve a float, serve down the line, unfortunately going too far wide. Give a chance for Vinort and Hannah to equalize. Delay at the moment is just trying to fix the sideline. Good power there by Giulietelli. Fun fact about Giulietelli, she just recently got engaged. So the combination of Tilly Polly may no longer be Tilly Polly. Next summer we may be seeing Polly Versteeg. But rest assured, it is still the same team, it's just a change of names. Vinort trying to go for the baby shot, we call it, where it's just a little light roll that's supposed to go over the block. Unfortunately, hitting that one into the net. And a service ace there by Giulietelli. We've seen some good aggression from Tilly Polly on the service. A combination of float and jump serves, and they're just making it a little bit more difficult for Hannah and Vinort to find their rhythm. Great swing there by Liz Hannah. Float serve. Well taken by Giulietelli. Chance to get a point, and unfortunately into the net there again. Good serves down the line there by Shauna Polly. Difficult serve to receive as the ball goes outside the player's platform, outside their body, and making them have to dig off balance. So it brings up our technical timeout. I mentioned that in the first set is when the scores equal a combination of 21. Both teams get a free timeout. And this is a good chance to talk a little bit about our other sponsors here at the GJ Gardner Homes New Zealand Beach Tour. A couple of our local sponsors that are sponsoring the tour. Big shout out to Proper Hand Cooked Chris, a local Nelson firm, as well as Cheer Sisters. And the delicious Little Beauties. Freeze-dried fruit was dipped in beautiful chocolate. We also have some of our sunscreen sponsors, Aloe Up, making sure that everyone out here is slip-slop slapped and wrapped. And of course, our events company, Beached As Events. Thanks to them, this tour would not be possible. Dirty Dogs providing the shades. And of course, the Nelson City Council for allowing us to use this Tahuna Nui Reserve here today and over this weekend. So first serve back after the technical timeout, Sean Apolli, service error into the net. Wind's just starting to pick up a little bit more out there. Great baby line there by Julia Tilley, just hitting it just over top of the block. As a blocker myself, I could say it's one of the most difficult ones to pick. You've jumped up, you see it drift over you, and you fall just as fast as the ball falls. Cheeky play there by the North. Going on two with a cross-court dig over the head. Just rolling along the top of the net and out. Service area there by Julia Tilley. Now we've seen a few more service areas here from Tilley Polly. They were dominating with the services in the first set. Again, another unsuccessful peel by Liz Hunter. It's very important that the feet are planted when you peel off the net. The moment the ball is contacted, you need to be stationary once you're off that net. Otherwise, your momentum's only going to drift the ball backwards, as we've seen a couple of times there by Liz Hunter. And that tags the tape of the sideline, meaning that ball goes in. With a great cross, a great line shot by Sean Apolli. Deep hit there by Melanie Vanur, and that brings up a side change of 18-10. Tilley Polly with a formidable lead here. Hannah Vanort will need to switch up something now before it's too late to get Lua back into this game. Good shot there by Liz Hunter down the line. That service is going too far wide, not what they need at this point in the game. Services are obviously important all throughout the game, but at this point when it's neck and, or not neck and neck, when they're close to the end of the set, you want to make sure that all your services are getting in. Good dig there, goes on two. Julia Tilley unable to get that one up. That's a great play there by Liz Hunter and Melanie Vanort. Now, like indoor volleyball, you have a maximum of three touches on each side. However, in beach volleyball, it's more common to see teams go on two than it is in indoor. Liz Hunter falling over and when approaching to block that ball, giving a free net for Giulietelli to hit back. And it brings up match point here in the first women's semi-final down here at the GJ Gardner Homes Nelson Super Slam, five-star tournament here on the New Zealand Beach Tour. And that finishes the game with a ace serve by Shauna Polly. And that means that Shauna Polly and Giulietelli will be moving on to the final, which kicks off at 2 p.m. today, and will be playing the winner of the next semi-final between Olivia McDonald and Alice Zeman, who will be taking on another pairing. We'll be coming back to you very shortly with that, but I'm your host, Trent Webby, and we'll see you shortly for the next women's semi-final.
Julia and Shauna, there are a great first up semi-final. First you, Julia, how's the form in the first tournament of 2021?
Yeah, well, I was very happy to have the serving on my side of the net. Yeah, Shauna was ripping some of those jump serves, which really helped us build some momentum, and yeah, we're really happy to get that win.
Yeah, Shauna, the first set there, those jump serves, that's something you've been working on in the off-season?
Not actually, but with a little bit of wind, sometimes I like to bust it out, and yeah, obviously got in a really good groove, so I thought I'd just keep going with it, and it worked in that first set, not so much in the second set, but yeah, hoping to carry that momentum into the final.
Absolutely, and just talking of the wind here, it's obviously a beautiful spot here at the Tahununui Beach Reserve. How did you find the conditions, Julia?
Yeah, really good. We like having a little bit of breeze. It kind of makes things interesting and strategically gives you something to think about. And yeah, really nice sand and beautiful day.
Okay, and a few work-ons for the final. What are some things you'll be working on as you head into the final?
I'm going to try to give Julia some better sets, get her in some better positions. But I think we're just going to really like do the basics well, and I think it'll be our game.
Okay, well, good luck in that final. We've found our first finalists, Giulietelli and Shauna Polly.
Thank you. Whoop, whoop.
You know, there's a reason more customers choose one New Zealand company to build their homes. Trust. GJ Gardner have worked up and down the country for over 20 years now, and they've earned a solid reputation with Kiwis. And you've just voted them Reader's Digest most trusted home builder again. So if you're thinking about creating the home you've always wanted, talk to the team at GJ Gardner Homes, New Zealand's most trusted home builder, officially.
The digital age means that your sport events can now be streamed live to national and global audiences with flexible delivery across multiple devices and platforms. NZSport.tv and Digital Vision Live work together to create multiple solutions for online broadcasting of sport events. We believe we make a real difference and provide a better live streaming experience. We can interface seamlessly with all broadcast options, including Sky Sport Live and Sky Sport Next, and simulcast to social media and other live TV. Digital Vision Live has also developed our own platform that provides a reliable and consistent stream with superior quality and unlimited viewership, as well as on-demand playback. This gives us full control over the broadcast and means we can adapt to the many challenges of a live sports production. We can also add pay-per-view options. For seamless streaming and consistent quality away from land-based internet, we use multiple cellular networks and we work directly with providers to develop network solutions if needed. Best of all, however, with everything we do, we can provide off-site production via remote studio or virtual server with mixing of multiple cameras, remote commentary and online scoring. This means a lower footprint at the venue and reduced costs. Another advantage, you can access as much of the platform as you wish and make use of multiple playlists for archived games and highlights and embed them on your own website. Together, nzsport.tv and Digital Vision Live utilise a wealth of experience to provide quality streaming of local, national and international events. Anything live streaming in sport, you should be talking to us. We are sure we can help.